welcome to this great celebration here today. And thanks for being here. It's a big moment for us and all of us. My name's Todd Winskowski. I'm Deputy Director of NDCC. It's my pleasure to be here and to celebrate this with you all. I've been fortunate to be on this project since day one in this latest iteration. And it's not often that you get to see a project go from vision, to reality. And that's what we're here to celebrate today, the next big step in that process. I'd like to introduce someone that we've worked closely with throughout the process, an ardent supporter and champion for the project. So please welcome District 9 Councilman and Council President Alvis Brooks.
Thanks, Todd. How y'all doing today? Come on, Rhino. This is historic. This is incredible. I mean, I remember the first time I got to Denver in 2001 from the University of Colorado, the Buffs that are returning to dominance again. But when I first got here, I remember coming down Brighton to a street that looked much different than it looks today. A street that there wasn't a lot of activity, and a street that I would never dream is where it is today. And one person said this and said, what is a city but its people? And Rhino is what it is today because of all of the individuals out there. You all made this a priority. You all worked hard as entrepreneurs, as leaders, and you're the only part of our community where I see the business community and artists coming together to develop something that's unique and distinct in this city. And so this is because of you, and we really thank you for that. I actually inherited this project, which is one of the coolest projects, from an incredible councilwoman. I want to give her some love, Judy Montero, who is not here. Give it up for her, please. Who made this a priority and worked really hard to make sure this works. But the thing that I'm most excited about is we went on a little trip to see a bicycle trip to really look at different type of bike lanes. And we have one cycle track in the city. Anybody know where it is? It's in front of the city and county building. It's about 100 feet. No, it's bigger than that. But it's not very big. But we will have a separated cycle track on Brighton the entire way because of the advocates in this audience. And so thank you all so much for making that a reality. I get a chance to introduce somebody who, you need people. Oh, shoot, the rhino just fell. That's okay, though. That's okay. He's tired. He's like, man, been working. I want to say this before I introduce Kelly Lead. There will be a lot of construction. There'll be some disruption, and you all in the meetings that we've had has helped us lessen that impact to businesses. But I would love for you all as leaders to help us during this disruption for the next couple months, and letting folks know transformation is underway, and every time you get upset, you get ticked off about what's going on, think about what we're going to look at in the next 12 to 18 months. Someone who really made this happen, you need people on different levels for a huge project like this. You need grassroots folks here at the community level making it happen. You need council folks. You need folks in the administration, and somebody who is a strong leader for NDCC when he was here is Kelly Lee. Now he's leading the National Western Center, so please bring it up for my man, Kelly Lee.
Good afternoon. Councilman, thank you so much for your partnership and for your introduction. And he's spot on. Is, projects like this do not happen by one individual, but it's a testament to so many faces out here I see in the crowd that have helped make this happen. And I especially want to call out Todd Winskowski and Erica Martinez, who were part. We were a team of three when we started this effort, and less than 3 years, we sit here today and we're breaking ground on a gateway into our city. So thank you guys for your work and everybody that has worked on this. I think this is a testament to what's to come. This is a start to something very special in this part of our city. And that really is kind of my theme, is that, 3 years ago, Mayor Hancock established the North Denver Cornerstone Collaborative. And the whole premise was we have six projects in this part of our city, Brighton being one of them, that instead of thinking about these as independent projects, let's bring them together, strategically align the planning, and ultimately their implementation. And when you do that, special things can happen, because let's be frank, the mayor and all of us have been really clear that this part of our city is very disconnected from the rest of our city. It's been the back door into Denver, which we're going to change with this project. But we've been working at this for 3 years now. And again, I think today is a celebration, a milestone of what can happen when you come together. It doesn't mean you always agree. We're as a family, families fight sometimes, but at the end of the day, on the big things, we came together to make it happen. You know, this street, this boulevard, it's not coincidental that this is the first big celebration, because a big part of this city, or the big part of this part of the this network, is that it's so disconnected. So the fact that we're in making a substantial investment in reconnecting it to the rest of Denver is an important theme to kick this off. You know, it's a gateway into our downtown. It's a gateway into this evolving and vibrant Reno Arts District. It's a main street into three existing historic neighborhoods, Glovelle area, Swansea. It's a road that historically has carried cattle and horses and will continue to do so. And it's a gateway and a front door to our river that we will restore ecologically. And again, I want to emphasize this, and I can't say it enough, that it's a testament to our shared will that we're starting off these six major projects with this project, that it's about connecting our city to the rest of our city. It's about honoring historic neighborhoods, and it's about honoring collaboration with the public and private sector. You know, when we started this in 2013, we moved pretty swiftly. We moved swiftly to get 30% design done, and then in 2015, the mayor made an enormous contribution through our general fund to the tune of $26 million, and then the private sector through the bid and JID stepped up and added another three. So we're kicking things off with a down payment of nearly $29 million towards this project to make it happen. Our teams worked tirelessly together. Again, we sometimes agreed to disagree, but at the end of the day, we're setting the mark with a multimodal transit system, a network that we'll all be proud of, and will really demonstrate a new northern gateway into our city. And with that, I think it's important to recognize our private sector partners, and I am so honored and so delighted to introduce Ann Hayes, who is the chair of the General Improvement District. And again, projects like this don't happen without both the public and private sector working together. So I want to thank all of you for being here, and I want to thank our private sector partners for stepping up, putting your money where your mouth is, and helping make this boulevard a reality. Ann, I'll turn it over to you.
Thanks, Kelly. And good morning, Rhino. Woo! Isn't this an exciting day? I mean, my goodness, think about, for all of you who have been involved in this, the amount of work, the number of the hours and hours and hours of meetings we've had, and all of the people who have helped bring us to this point. It is so exciting to finally arrive on this beautiful day. We're going to start building this corridor. So it's awesome to get started, and there's a lot of people to thank. And that's what I'm mostly going to do, is I'm going to thank some people that have really helped bring us to this point, starting with some of the early movers and shakers in this neighborhood. And I want to mention, the first person I want to mention is Tracy Weil. It was his idea a long time ago that Rhino exists. Even the Rhino name, I believe, was his idea. And so thank you, Tracy, for all of that original thought early on. And then some of the other two guys, and there were many, but I'm going to mention Justin Croft and Andy Feinstein, who helped organize this neighborhood and come up with some of the early priorities that shaped the design of the corridor. And they include a priority for pedestrian traffic and bicycle traffic and stormwater, water quality, so that we can deliver precious clean water to our precious river. So thank you guys for all of your efforts early on and all the early organizing. But in addition to that, I want to primarily thank the neighborhood. When we made the decision to form the General Improvement District and the Business Improvement District, we needed the neighborhood to support us in that. And as you all, I think most of you know, the General Improvement District helped provide some additional dollars so that we could embellish the corridor with things like street trees and pedestrian lighting and crosswalks. So it's going to even be more special. So thank you, community, for voting yes to help fund those items and help maintain them over time. Other people that I want to mention is Bike Denver and Walk Denver, who also helped with the design. And then the primary designers, CH2M Hill and R&L. They helped, they went to a lot of meetings with us. They helped us through the process. They involved us. They listened to us. And they integrated all of our thinking into the final design for the corridor. Andy Mountain from GBSM, who tirelessly helped kept us organized in all of our meetings. So thank you, Andy. Jamie Litko and Allie Sharp, thank you. You guys worked tirelessly to help us get organized and to form these districts and to do it successfully, which was so important to get to today. And as well, and again, all of this was a very collaborative process between all of the private and public entities. And it, you know, it's really a testament for everyone, you know, keeping our eyes on that final goal of this creating a really wonderful corridor and a great neighborhood. And now we're fortunate to have Kiewit Construction. Thank you, Kiewit, as our contractor. I had personal experience with Kiewit down at Denver Union Station. I was involved with that project as well. They did a masterful job. I am so excited to have Kiewit as our contractor. They're going to do a great job. They've got a proven track record of excellent work, staying on schedule. And I will say, and I will reiterate it, that it will be disruptive. This is going to be a disruptive process. We have to be patient. We have to listen to what they're telling us to do. And it'll be well worth it in a couple years when we have a wonderful new corridor. And not only for this project, but for all of the investment that this project has spurred on. You know, our company is one of them. There's many on the corridor. There's all kinds of construction happening along this corridor. It's going to be completely transformed in a couple years. So in conclusion, I don't want to forget to mention the person whose idea I think this was, and that is our own Mayor Hancock. And thank you so much for your support, your generous investment in this neighborhood, and also to Councilman Brooks. Thank you so much for your leadership, and it's just exciting to get going. So thank you, everyone.
Good morning, everyone. It's been a long way to get here. It's been a very long project getting here today, working together with planning, with capital projects, with transportation and mobility team. It's been a true effort to get to Denver, one of the first multi-model corridor that we're going to be very proud to build. By the end of 2017, you will be commuting along a corridor that looks much different than it does today. As we make innovative improvements to redevelop Brighton Boulevard into a better and safer place for everybody, for pedestrians, for bikes, for cars, for residents, this project is going to add 2.6 miles of sidewalk to enhance walkability in the neighborhood. And more than 100 benches will be offered for convenience and rest. Two new traffic lights will be installed along Brighton Boulevard at 33rd and 35th Street, as well as the improvement of the traffic lights on 31st and 38th Street. We're also going to carve out about 80 on-street parking spaces, and you're going to see 2.5 miles long bicycle track on both sides of Brighton Boulevard. Woo! These are race protected bike lanes, which are going to separate the vehicles from pedestrians traffic, providing greater safety and comfort and connectivity along the corridor. Other amenities are also being added along this corridor to help keep our city sustainable. Brighton will be soon the home of the first green infrastructure of its kind, as we plant more than 400 trees, and we're going to add about 28,000 square feet of water quality feature along the corridor. Brighton also is going to be one of the first streets in Denver that is going to be designed with energy efficiency LED streetlights. And finally, I would like to give a special shout out to public works staff and everybody else that helped to make today's groundbreaking a reality. First of all, Leslie Thomas, I'm not sure if she's here today, our city engineer. George Delaney, Denver Public Works Chief Operating Officer, who is going to be responsible to continue maintaining this street in good shape. Dave Hansinger, our Director of Capital Project Management. Thanks, David. Brian McLaren, our Project Manager for this job. Karen Good, our Lead Planner. Sarah Anderson, for your expertise on water quality. Thank you, Sarah. And there are many others: Emily Glockner, Chrissy Fanganello, Emily Snyder, Justin Smith, Amy Renz, all of you that work in providing a truly multimodal corridor for the city of Denver. Thank you so much. Also, want to shout out to CH2M Hill and RNL, our lead designers, and Hewitt, our contractor. The Brighton Blvd redevelopment project would not be here without your help and your expertise. And leading this charge, as everybody else has mentioned, on creating this new improved gateway into our city is our mayor, Mayor Michael B. Hancock. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Good morning, everyone. The benefit of going last is that everybody has said what I was scheduled to say. So the speech is absolutely useless. But they have said all that needs to be said and the importance of this project and really the wonderful features. I want to just add a couple exclamation marks to that. First of all, in 2013, when Kelly and I sat down and I told him I was changing his job, I don't think either one of us really understood how critical that decision would be to put focus and point of emphasis on this area of town. We kind of sensed that this was a special opportunity, but we didn't know, I think, the depth of what I was asking him to do, or what he was agreeing to ultimately do. And I hope you agree with me that his involvement, his leadership on the six major projects initially has absolutely been transformative. So thank you, Kelly Lee, your efforts. I also want to thank Gretchen Hollera, the Deputy Director of Finance, as well as Deputy Director of this effort here in the National Western Center, Erica Martinez and Michael Sapp, who are working on communications and community efforts. Yes, you can give them some love. And certainly want to acknowledge the presence of our North Denver Cornerstone Collaborative team, starting with Anna Jones, the director, Todd Winskowski, who you've already met, Chris Pacheco, Morgan Hartley, and Michelle Faust, who are making it happen with our six. They've assumed the leadership of these projects. To Jose Cornejo and the entire Public Works team, we are grateful for your leadership. This project would not move forward without you. And we're fortunate to have a partner in City Council with the visionary, energetic, vivacious, effervescent, handsome, athletically built. Keep going, you said? Councilman Albus Brooks, who fights hard for his constituents every day. And I gotta thank him as well. And I gotta tell you, we know this is taking a long time. The reason why former Councilwoman Montero has had to hand this off to Councilman Brooks because it took too damn long. We're here now, though, and we're moving forward with this project. Let me just give you one framework, and then we're going to move some dirt. I had a very surreal experience as a mayor when the chief financial officer walks in your office and says, "You have a one-time, unbelievable opportunity. We have extra capital money to invest in the city. One time project." And it totaled $28 million. And as a mayor, you start to salivate. It's like, are you kidding me? This never happens. But the city had been performing so well, and businesses have been hiring, and people of Denver have been purchasing, and we have begun as people of the city lift our city up out of the recession so well. And typically as a mayor, politically you think, how do I take care of council members? I could probably give them all $2 million and say, find me your favorite project that we can invest in. But I'm glad that the wisdom of that day sat at the table and we said, find that one catalytic project that we can invest in that will absolutely transform an area of this town. And the staff went back and they compiled a list of maybe 3 or 5 projects. Now I want you to understand something. I travel Brighton Boulevard every day. I have not been shy about the fact that I thought this was the ugliest gateway to downtown and anywhere in the country. That we as a city can do better, and we had to find a way to do better. That's why Kelly was placed in this area. When I looked and saw that Brighton Boulevard was on that list, it was a no-brainer. That if we can invest $25 to $27 million, we can redesign Brighton Boulevard. Get sidewalks, get tree lines, and then the design about bikes came later when the community got involved. And so today we are here breaking ground on a construction project that has truly been a collaborative effort. City Council, the Finance Office, my administration, the community, the GID, various businesses, small business owners, big business owners, the residents of this area who stood up and said this is the right investment. Today, instead of taxi drivers telling me, as they did once before, that they would avoid coming down Brighton and take their passengers down around I-25 to get downtown, all of us are excited to drive down Brighton every day just to see what else is new along Brighton Boulevard. Would you not agree?
Yeah.
And so as I close, yeah, we're going to feel a little pain, but anything worth having is going to hurt just a little bit. And so I'm excited that we're here today to break ground. I'm excited what this is going to bring to this community. And you already are seeing the economic impacts of the decision to make that catalytic investment. It was the right move, and we're at the right place at the right time. And so with that said, let's move some dirt and get this party started.